This is European style.
So we have two different types of tanks here, and these ones are from the Soviet Union times. But we are still using them.
Okay.
So inside they have steel, and outside they are covered with foam to keep the temperature inside.
Okay.
But everything starts from these tanks. So at first they pour only grape juice in each one, where it goes through the fermentation and becomes dry wine. So no sugar, more alcohol. Then these tanks have refrigerators inside, which means that we can control the temperature. Make semi-sweet, semi-dry and sweet wines. And how? We are using -3, -2. We freeze wine, stop the fermentation, and then we can maintain sugar. And of course they have some standards. For instance, semi-dry wine should have 18 grams sugar per liter. Semi-sweet wines, 25 grams. Sweet wines, 30. So they know and they guess more easily which kind of wine is inside. For example, sugar is less than 20 grams. It's semi-dry. When we want to make it semi-sweet, we stop this fermentation for longer time. But it also takes 3 weeks in total. After that, we move the wines into the tanks with the pipes for the storage. Nothing will be changed inside.
So here, how many months you store? Because there in traditional 6 months, and here
maybe 1 or 2 years.
2 years.
That's for the storage. Sweet wine, younger is always better. Dry wine, older is always better.
Oh, okay.
But of course, it's not finished when we keep wine in clay vessels for 6 months, because after we are using barrels, bottles for aging and young. It takes.
So this also you will show us where you do the aging.
Yeah.
And here the aging is happening here, right?
Also here, yeah.
But do you have any other aging process for this?
Well, as I told you, nothing will be changed inside. Not the taste, color or something. So it's just for the storage.
Storage.
Depends on our winemaker. How many times you want to keep wine?
Oh, okay.
Wine.
Wine? Yeah. So they are wine also. But in plastic bottles.
Okay.
Because nowadays it's more family and like traditional thing for us. Georgians always buy this kind of bottles for feasts and suppers.
So here you make the juice and you, after the fermentation you will transfer here.
Exactly. Yeah.
And at what stage you put it in, transfer to the barrels? When you will transfer to the barrel?
It also depends on our winemaker. Because for example, nothing is changing here.
Yeah.
So we can just take out this wine after 2 or 3 weeks and keep it in the barrel.
Okay. And in barrel also nothing will change.
In the barrel, yeah.
It will change. Okay.
Because it's oak. And when it's getting older, it can change wine taste with a bit of weight.
Okay.
More like spicy flavors, more tannins, and wine will become more stronger and sour.
Yes.
That's why the maximum to put wine in barrel is 4 years only.
So if it is a traditional dry wine, then how old it is? It has more taste.
Exactly.
If
but sweet wine,
latest
it
one.
Should be 1 or 2 years.
Maximum.
At least, yeah.
But it will not go bad, right? Even if you keep for more years.
Sure.
It will go
until
waste.
Until you open the bottle.
Okay.
You can keep it for a long time, 20 years, 30. But once you open the bottle,
okay.
You should keep it in the fridge. Otherwise, fermentation starts again.
Dad, don't you worry.
Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
So here how many liters you can make?
So? More. Because from our production, Georgian is only 40%. It's
60. Okay.
For example, each one contains 20,000 liters.
20,000.
How many?
And there each one contains 2,000. Yeah. 20,000 and 2,000. Yeah.
So for example, what do you think? How many bottles this corporation produces per year? Per year.
Millions, no?
What do you think? How many bottles per year?
How many bottles?
Maybe 12 million? 12 million?
Not that much, but 5 million.
5.
But actually in Georgia, that's
more than
much, yeah. Because some companies are producing only maybe 2,000, 3,000 bottles, and this corporation, 5 million.
And so you export?
Yeah, so 80% goes for export.
Which country you?
Mostly Germany.
Germany.
Then China.
Okay.
Poland.
So here also this, how they will clean here, this tank, no
what
cleaning.
What do you think, how? The same thing.
Broom.
You will open that, go inside and swim.
Swim.
Yeah, one person should go inside, that's why it's really scary too. But Georgian wine is always more expensive than European.
Mm.
Because it's more artificial.
Man-made.
We can make different kinds of wines, but Georgian is more unique because we produce wines without any movement.
But still, here you are not adding any.
No, nothing.
Okay.
We just can't control the fermentation.
Mm. Okay. So this is the empty tank. So this process usually you do in the month of September, right?
Yeah, September and October. So you should come back for this time because you can see all active processes, check the grape and also drink wine. Like.
So what in the remaining months, what the people's workers will do?
Come again?
Remaining time during there is no process.
Yeah.
Where what?
We are just keeping wines. Like that.
So workers, workers will still come
workers
to the...
Workers will come, yeah, tomorrow.
Hmm.
Because
today.
Yeah, that's why. But actually this place is so crowded because we have more than 200 workers.
Hmm.
And in September and October, we have more than 150 groups a day.
Ah, okay.
They open the factory at 9.
Okay.
And before we open the factory outside, 5 or 6 groups are waiting.
And what is this for? This is for...
Also for European style. Sorry, same.
No, the for... This is... What process is happening?
Storage.
Storage only.
Yeah. So fermentation happens only there.
Oh, okay.
So after they just move this wine here. It's easier because also they have refrigerators. And hot weather doesn't have any impact.
Okay.
And they use this machine to crush the grapes.
Ah, okay.
They receive the grapes also.
So this is for Europe?
European, yeah, easier.
Machine.
And where you keep the barrels?
Barrels? In European wine cellar, basement.
Mm.
So now we have to see that face, which is quite interesting.
These are the parts, right?
Yeah, also the same size.
Yeah.
We use them until they are broken, but if it happens, we don't take them out. Like, we can replace them.
Mm-hmm.
But actually, these clay vessels last for a long time because we have some of them from
1924. Wow. Yeah. Some parts. Samma smell.
Which comes from distilled wine, but for normal wines, they are using this kind of bottles. In the cellar, US Embassy have their own shelf. They are keeping their wines. And also you can see private customer names. These are the people who have rented the storage places in this cellar. You can have your own shelf.
So they do they need to pay for you?
Sure. Yeah, it will be 150 lari per year.
Still cheap.
Not so, yeah, expensive actually.
150 lari per year is, yeah.
You have to buy at least 15 bottles, 1-5. Mm. Then they write your name on the shelf. After 5 or 10 years, you can come back, bring your friends and show them your shelf in Georgia wine cellar. Mm. Or take this bottle and take them.
So this is like just for aging purpose.
Just for aging. Because in the cellar we have better conditions, appropriate temperature. There are some people who come here once a year. They change the corks from every bottle, they have to move them. And that's why it's people paying money, because they don't have to do it instead of them.
They need to change what? Cork?
Corks, yeah.
Why we need to change?
Also, that's the same. When this oak is getting older, it can change wine taste.
Ah, okay. இங்க பாத்தியடா எல்லாரும் வைன் வாங்கி வச்சிருக்காங்க பாரு.
In the cellar we have 17,000 bottles. All of that we have wine inside.
Okay. So this all they buy and they store. It's same like the bank. Red wine for sure.
Sure. And also these drinks are numbered because they know you want to use them. This one is 0
for Jackson. Because it's older. People here. So these are traditional Georgian wines or European? So this small barrel, these are for European
style.
Even the steel tank?
Steel tank, yeah.
That also for Georgian?
That's for European style.
Okay. Why are they horizontally stored? No. Maybe just the wine to touch the cork?
Sure. Wine has to touch the cork.
Yeah.
When you keep wines upright, this cork will dry out. Something will go down and spoil wine.
Yeah.
So that's the correct position to keep wine for a long time. And these bottles are in different position because it's sparkling wine, like champagne. They also have the structure. For example, sparkling wine needs to fermentation.
Okay.
Second one should be in the bottle, which takes 15-20 days. During this time, they add yeast to make this fermentation faster. Then they move these bottles, like treating. And after the first one, they leave the signs. After, they come here each day, turn these bottles to know the position of them.
Mm.
It's for the bubbles. They also change yeast and corks. For example, they freeze the top of the bottle.
Mm.
It's more easy to take out yeast or deposit it, then put another cork inside.
So, when they keep the bottle like this, the wine is touching the cork fully, right? So, why they need to turn?
Because it's sparkling wine.
Okay.
They add yeast here. Then they move it for bubbles.
Oh, okay.
And we have this instruction. For example, now these bottles have the sign here.
Yeah.
That's the first day.
Okay.
Tomorrow, they will come here and turn this button.
Okay.
So it's like second fermentation.
And this also storage, right?
That's also for storage.
But here there is no name.
Because this bottles belong to our collection. We do a vintage special collection for wines, and you can also buy them.
Mm. Is it so?
Not every wine will be good or drinking. Every wine has their ages for drinking, for aging, preserving.
Okay.
For example, some wines have really good potential for aging, but some wines don't. That's why we have special wines. Well, for example, Saperavi, red dry wine, Kisi, white dry wine, and we can keep them for a long time. And why? These grapes grow special microzones. It should rain at least once a month, so we don't harvest these grapes every year.
Okay.
We have to wait for the time that comes only once in 5 years. And these wines are more costly.
Okay. So when you sell the wine in the shop or retailers, how they know this wine can be stored for this many years or this many months?
It's impossible. They can get it from the bottles because it's not written. But as I told you, dry wine is always good for aging. Sweet wine never. Well, this wall is a part of the castle, like palace, that was built by King Levan in the 16th century. Levan was the king of this region, Ahati, and as I told you, at first we had one cellar where people were making wine for royal family, so this is part of that. In this palace, what do you think? What we have inside?
Brandy or
brandy, which is from 2008. If you want, you can open and smell it.
It is from 2008?
Yeah, 2008. But if you answer my questions, then you will be able to open and smell.
I already answered one question there.
Well, the first question is, what was the main difference between European and Georgian technologies?
No, there you are controlling the fragmentation. Here you are not controlling the fragmentation.
This is man-made and it is pure, natural.
So, what are we using for Georgian style and not for European?
Georgian style, everything.
Everything, whole grapes and European, not the juice.
Juice.
Which is more sweet, dry or semi-dry?
Semi-sweet.
Semi-sweet or semi-dry?
Semi-sweet.
Sweet or semi-dry?
Both sweet. You are asking question.
Which is more sweet? Semi-dry or sweet?
Semi-sweet.
Sweet, of course. Is it busy? Then, now we can
do it. Open. Which one? Anything you can open or?
Yeah, you can. That will be easy to open. So brandy comes from distilled wine. Now it has 40% alcohol.
Okay.
So it's easier than chacha. Because for chacha, we use double distillation. After that, chacha has 50% alcohol. And also it has sweeter taste. It doesn't
fire. I want to pick you there. So how distilled, how you, this is like artificial or naturally? All these are brandy?
Exactly. So all this brandy in our wine shop is Mama Bapuri, which is 23 years old.
Yeah. So, more older, more costly, expensive.
More older, more expensive, but only in the shop you can find brandy.
We can take a picture here.
Yeah, which is old. You look younger. Yeah, like I always thought that you were sisters.
So the brandy you can make from both wines, from both
white and red. Yeah, because when we use distillation, this color is disappearing.
Okay, but it can be done from traditional and even from European
even
style.
From European, yeah.
So this is grapes tree, right? Grapes.
No, not grapes.
No.
corporation also has own vineyards.
Okay.
195 hectares.
Mm.
In this region.
Your company, this company, sir.
This company, yeah. Quite only one corporation in Georgia. So these bottles are ready.
Okay.
And as I told you, they are building the traditional wine cellar. Here. We are expanding.
Ah, okay.
And there will be a pool upstairs. Wine pool.
Wine pool. So next time, if we come,
you
we
should come. Yeah.
When are you expecting to finish this work?
I think it takes like 1 year.
1 year?
Yeah, not more.
So even if we come next year, we cannot see.
Exactly.
Maybe a week later.
So the last part that we have to see is laboratories.
Okay.
Well, not every wineries have their own laboratories in Georgia.
Okay. Ah.
We have certificate of ISO.
So only 22,000.
Mm-hmm.
No, 9,000.
Yeah, more. There is a lab where they check almost every bottles. Each tank, clay pot, barrel, so they are taking samples from them.
Every bottle or every tank?
Tank.
Every.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So they check the quality here.
Okay.
Grapes, content of sugar. After when we produce wines, they are checking content of alcohol in these tanks, and other wineries or local people can bring their grapes.
Oh.
So we give this service also to them.
With the chargeable.
So it's
bottles you do automatic packaging,
yeah.
Not manual. Okay. So this is the final step.
Exactly. Great. Are you ready for the best part?
Yes.
Tasting.
Yes.
Yes.
Degustation.
Yes.
Let's go. Yes. So this is one lab, right?
Exactly, there is one lab.
Maybe here we can take one picture.
Yeah, so these are the plants where we export our whites.
He is very excited.
He's so excited.
Dai. Hansen, wait.
For you.
Mm-hmm.
You
want
plenty to taste, huh? Do you like
to taste
some wine?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Some sweet
one. Okay.
I'll go inside the ground now. Vena, please, Vena.
But you can, I think, second time. Yeah.
Yeah, that's up to you.
Yeah, you can.
Why is kisik berry white dry wine? So kisik, that's the type of grape, and berry means clay pot, which is buried in the ground. So this wine is made in clay vessels by Georgian traditional style. We used other parts of the grapes, skin, seed and stems. That's why it has more dark color, like amber, and you will notice that also. It has 13% alcohol, 1 in 8. So at first we need small glasses. Small, yeah.
Very little, okay?
It's enough?
Yeah.
Oh, so little for her.
Yeah, little for us.
Enough.
Just for tasting. But if you can finish, you can pour wine here.
So this is with grape, seed, all the stuff.
Yeah,
you?
At first, you should smell it before tasting, then we spare glasses. That helps you open flavors and aromas inside. After we smell it again to see the differences, and then we drink it.
Yeah.
What do you think about the taste?
Good.
Sour. Because it has lots of tannins that makes your mouth dry and leaves strong flavors also here. So it's because of skins.
In some restaurants I saw the people make like this. Mm-hmm. This is for what reason?
Well, they because keep the quality of wine and also it helps you open flavors.
Mm.
For example, now we can try the next one and also I will explain how to do that.
Let's try the next one.
Sweet, appa.
So the next wine is sweeter. So same grape but different version. Sent wine, which is made in bigger tanks, the second place that we have seen, with only grape juice. So now this, you see the tanks are not used, and that's why just look at the color difference.
Water.
So it's kind of sweet. I think you will like this more.
It smells sweet.
It smells
sweet.
I know.
Sweet, huh?
It smells
sweet,
but bad.
I try, but for this also sour.
Also
this
sour?
Is semi-sweet or?
Slightly semi-sweet. So we stop the fermentation. It has less alcohol, 11%, and more sugar.
So this one have 11% alcohol, and the first one have 13%.
The 13%. Which wine did you like the most?
Second.
Yeah, and
now I will show you what we are doing. So we are swirl our glasses like that. For example, at first when you smell this wine, it smells fruity. After swirling, you feel more alcohol. Then, after shaking, when some wine leaves thicker drops on the glass, it means that wine has good quality. Wine has the body. Wine tears, wine legs. As fast they go down, it has more alcohol. As slowly they go down, less alcohol it has. But it was kept in barrels for more flavors. So it's more rich. It has more flavors than other wines. That's why we use bigger glass. So red wines need more space, more oxygen to be carbonated, and it has higher alcohol, 13.5%.
Okay.
It will be kind of
stronger.
Little, very little. Enough.
So you want more?
No, no. Little. Yeah.
He's like Georgian man.
But he is not drinking. He is everything is
putting.
உன் மூஞ்சிலே தெரிஞ்சிச்சு உனக்கு பிடிக்கலன்னு ஆக்ட் பண்ணாத.
You
cannot even drink?
But this wine would be amazing with red meat, the main dish, barbecue, beef or something. Because when you have, when you don't have some food, it's really hard to drink wine. But now it's European. Semi-sweet wine. As I told you, semi-sweet, semi-dry or sweet wine is never made in a plane.
Yeah.
So if wine is semi-sweet, it must be European style only.
Very little. Enough, enough.
It has more purplish, like pinkish color, as you see.
And you make sweet wines also?
Sweet wine. But only one sweet wine. Which is more ice wine.
And that one have 22%. That is having 22% sweet, right?
Well, sweet wine has 30 grams of sugar.
And semi-sweet have 22 grams. 25. No problem. You have sweet wine that also make from the same sugar, same grapes or different grapes?
Same grapes.
But you will not stop the fragmentation.
And also it's about late harvest.
You have that one for taste?
Yeah.
Full sweet. Yeah. Just can you give
it? Also, will you try that 16 sweet wine?
Yeah, I just want to.
Yes.
Here you don't have any old wine display?
No, not here.
Okay, see you.
See you.
See you. Bye.
Again.
Thank you. Sure. Maybe next time in September, October.
Okay.
On Chacha?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.